A former Minister of Works and Transport and parliamentary representative for San Fernando West, Sadiq Baksh would like to be remembered as someone who was there to help in the social and economic development of Trinidad and Tobago.
I've served and I see myself in the service of the people still, but at a different level.
Like Sadiq Baksh, Manohar Ramsaram also served as a minister in the United National Congress government of former Prime Minister Basudeo Pandey from 1995 to 2000, and then again in 2001. Mr. Ramsaran describes Sadiq Baksh as the person who introduced him to politics when they met Basudeo Pandey at a birthday party just prior to the 1995 general elections.
At that time I was a public servant. I had no intention of becoming a politician. But Mr. Pandey insisted that I, and Sadiq Baksh too, insisted that I run for election in Chaguanas. And that's how I got into politics. So Sadiq Baksh played a pivotal role in my becoming a member of parliament.
Sadiq Baksh was born here on the Saparia Ore Road in a little village nestled between Faizabad and Saparia. He got his early schooling at the Saparia Presbyterian Primary School before moving to San Fernando to attend the Asja Boys College. From Asja, he joined the then premier oil company in the country, Texaco Trinidad, as a trainee, going on to enroll the San Fernando Technical Institute and eventually joining the University of the West Indies St. Augustine campus to pursue studies in production management. He says he joined the Black Power movement in 1970 and decided not to pursue a career in the oil industry, the expatriate Texaco having been a major target of Black Power protest.
So Winston Sweet was my first leader, basically, with Wayne Davis and all the others that were involved, Rafik Shah and company, in the 1970s as a young man. And then I went into business after the events of 1970. Most of us went separate ways. I went into the manufacturing sector, basically because Faizabad was then a hotbed. So I left Faizabad and went into the East-West Corridor.
It was not until 1994 that Sadiq Baksh became involved in so-called conventional politics. That was when he agreed to assist in the management of the UNC and its efforts to win the Pointe-à-Pitre seat that became vacant following the death of PNM Pointe-à-Pitre representative Cyril Rajaram. He says he was asked to run for the seat but did not yet have any interest in pursuing electoral politics.
But I did volunteer to assist in the management of the campaign and to manage the party in this constituency with or without a candidate. And the rest is history. Gideon Hanuman Singh was the candidate. We won, and that began my involvement in the politics, management of politics.
That Pointe-à-Pitre victory catapulted Sadiq Baksh from his management of constituency politics to organizing and managing politics on a national scale, making a name for himself as the UNC's foremost election strategist and campaign manager, and setting him on the road to parliament. But when Sadiq Baksh began his parliamentary life in 1995, it was as a government senator. And it was during his stint in the upper house that he was appointed Minister of Works and Transport. He eventually went on to occupy a seat on the government benches in the House of Representatives after winning the San Fernando West seat in general elections in both 2000 and 2001. He relinquished the seat after losing to the People's National Movement's Diane Sukaran in 2002.
In fact, I have the record of running for the same constituency three times in 2 years. I won twice and was not successful on the third occasion.
It was during Sadiq Baksh's brief stay in the House of Representatives between 2001 and 2002 that serious terminal problems would develop in the UNC government, eventually leading to the government's collapse and to the formation of a third political party, the Congress of the People.
As a matter of fact, we also started the COP when we had our problems with Mr. Pandey, and we remember I went to the backbench before Winston Dukaran and Ganga Singh and Yet Ming, and us. Sadiq Baksh was the other politician in the formation of the COP.
Sadiq Baksh says management of the UNC's political campaigns was based on his personal policy of getting people to take responsibility. And it was that policy that he would take to the Ministry of Works and Transport, focusing his efforts from the bottom upwards.
So that whereas I had a hands-on approach, I took really the responsibility to mobilize the daily paid employees. Because the daily paid employees were the ambassadors of the ministry. They were the ones who people would see on the highways and byways, where I would have met with the directors in the ministry on a weekly basis. Every Monday morning, I would have met with the daily paid employees 5 times a week.
And I want to tell you, Sadiq Baksh is that type of leader, all inclusive, if you want to use that term. He allows people freedom to give their views, and then of course he will sift those views and make the final decisions. As he himself said, the buck stops with him.
Mr. Baksh says he began his 5 years of parliamentary life and ministerial life by looking at laws to deal more effectively and efficiently with traffic management and generally to better manage the air, land and sea transportation sectors. He pinpoints as the high point of his tenure the improvements in air, land and sea mobility, and the construction of bridges across the country.
I had the great opportunity to participate in the transformation of the Ministry of Works and Transportation that saw the implementation of the improvements of the National Highways Program to a lot of bridges and roads in the country. And that was a period in which the roads were really in a deplorable condition.
Among those road projects, there's one that occupies a proud place in the mind of this former Minister of Works and Transport. It is the St. Anne's Roundabout in Port of Spain, a project that involves some unique engineering manipulation to get streams of traffic flowing easily in a number of different directions. He admits that the idea was really the brainchild of former PNM Member of Parliament and Attorney at Law Desmond Alum Senior Counsel, who had produced a design which he had in his possession for several years, but which he had hitherto never been able to get implemented.
He's also from Faisalabad, and immediately I took office, he brought it to my attention. And really, a lot of the good ideas in the ministry didn't really come from me. It came from other people.
For example, he says, the dualing of this bridge across the Karani River was an idea that came from a popular Karani resident known as Mr. Lapai.
So basically what it was is that I was able to interact with citizens, and they drew to my attention things that were on the drawing board for a long time. I just was in the right place at the right time, had competent people in the Ministry of Works and Transportation, had a government that was willing to really work to satisfy the fundamental and basic needs of the people, and I really just implemented it.
Of the many other projects that were pursued under the watch of Sadiq Baksh as Minister of Works and Transport, this multi-million dollar Piyoko International Airport Terminal building stands out both in terms of size and controversy. And when we spoke with Mr. Baksh at his marvelous San Fernando business place, he was still embroiled in a long-standing legal battle to clear his name of charges arising out of the massive construction project. But notwithstanding all the controversy surrounding it, Sadiq Baksh still views the Piyoko project as being crucially important to the economic development of Trinidad and Tobago.
It is an important piece of infrastructure for the new economy of Trinidad and Tobago that must emerge. If Trinidad and Tobago is to become the financial center of the region, the airport is a definite part of that infrastructure.
Happily married, Sadiq Baksh and his wife Champa have 3 children, 2 boys and a girl. They are also the grandparents of 2. He's a devout Muslim with a passion for cricket, having excelled from time to time in friendly games involving his former parliamentary colleagues. He has been involved in this family business since 1984, manufacturing plastic products on the one end and home construction and real estate on the other. He is also the chief executive officer of the Trinidad and Tobago Civil Rights Organization, and he does not see any renewed involvement in electoral politics in his foreseeable future.
I've really never left the political arena, But I really do not see myself really getting involved in the cut and thrust of electoral politics at this time.
And what takes precedence in his life at this time?
Helping people takes precedence.
His friend, Manohar Ramsaram, does not see Sadiq Baksh being completely absent from the political landscape.
Of course, Sadiq has much to contribute. Sometimes I think anybody's life out of office or out of the limelight, you feel like that. But I think he's not a, what you call, old person. He has many years left that he could contribute. And I'm sure if called upon, he will make a good contribution. I have that confidence.